Howdy partners, and welcome back to Gal. I am here in Montana, hence the cowboy hat. Sony sent me out here for this awesome camera camp with other creators. We've been testing different Sony gear, and last night I won the RX100, which I have right here. It's pretty cool, little mirrorless compact camera, and the quality is pretty spectacular. I've been playing around with the menu settings, and it's a perfect scenery to do some time-lapse footage. So I thought it'd be great to show you guys how you can use the RX100 and the Syrup to create a cool moving time lapse. So let's go ahead and jump on in. All right, you guys, so I have the Syrup right now on the Joby, and I've attached the RX100 on top of it. And to add a little space, I added a little kind of accessory here that separates the base of the Syrup between the RX100. Because it's a point and shoot camera, the lens was actually touching the base, so they recommend putting something in between, like a ball head or whatever you have to do that. So you'll want to make sure that you charge up the Syrup with a USB first. So now it's fully charged, you just turn it on like that. And be sure to get the right linking cable so you can link it with whatever camera you're working with. So I have the RX100, it's a Sony, and it plugs in via USB. So once that's all plugged in, the next thing to do is to connect it by getting the app. So you have the Syrup Genie 2 app, so I'm going to turn that on. And then you just want to make sure to connect it. So once it's connected, this is where you get a bunch of different settings. So I'm going to choose from the time-lapse setting. And you can choose from different presets. So I'm going to choose clouds because right now we're in a cloudy scene. So I'm going to hit clouds. And then what I want to do is choose a direction of the time-lapse. So I want to do 180 degrees. So you can take this and you can say, oh, I want it to go counterclockwise or clockwise. So I want this to go counterclockwise. I'm going to drag it all the way to 180 degrees, like so. And then you can choose the interval and the recording time. So I'm going to choose the interval to be 5 seconds. I think that's good. And then you can choose a record time. So we can adjust this. Let's say we only want to shoot for 30 minutes. So it'll tell you how long the play time will be. So we're going to be shooting for 30 minutes. We're going to take a shot every 5 seconds. And then once the time lapse is done, it'll be a total of 12 seconds long. So then turn on the camera here, like so. Make sure your settings are good first. I'm going to adjust it at an f-stop of 7. And then on this app, all we're going to do is hit record. So after you hit the record, now this camera is going to be moving because the Syrup will shift over this 30 minute duration and take a photo every 5 seconds. And once it's done, we'll be able to see the final effect. So it's gonna slowly move 180 degrees around this beautiful lake. So hopefully it turns out, and we'll see in about 30 minutes. All right, we're here at the National Glacier Park. It is so beautiful here. We had to do some more time lapse. This time I'm using the Sony A7 III on the Genie. It's the same setup, the same connection, just a little bit heavier of a camera and a full frame sensor. So we're gonna do a little 120 degree time lapse of this water here, controlling it with the app on my phone, and then we'll see how it looks. I also wanted to tell you guys, this video was recorded with the Comica lavalier microphone set. It's pretty cool, it's new. I've never used Comica before, but we used it in this video to test it out, and it worked great. You can use it with your smartphone or your DSLR. And what I really like about it is that it's super lightweight, and it takes 3 AAA batteries, and you can have 2 lavaliers recording at once. So if you guys are interested in checking it out, I'll put a link in the description box below. All right, now that we're done shooting, what we need to do is turn all of that sequence of photos into one continuous moving picture into a video. So let's jump into Premiere and I'll give you guys a little tutorial on how to do that.
So once you're back in your computer,
take all of your photos that you took during the time lapse and put it into one folder, and be sure to remove any photos out of that sequence that you do not want included. So once you create a folder, then you're going to go back to Premiere and go up to File, then Import. And then from here, you're going to go into that folder. You're just going to select the first photo of the sequence, then click on Options, then make sure to select Image Sequence and then hit Import. And this is where you can rename it. So let's just call it Flathead Lake Time-lapse. And Premiere defaults to 29.97 frames per second. If you're working in a 24 frames per second sequence, you're going to want to update that. So you're going to control click on this and go to Modify, Interpret Footage, and then change this to assume this frame rate, and then just type in 24 frames per second and hit OK. And then what we can do is create a new sequence, and we can make it a, let's say, digital SLR 1080p 24 frames per second and hit OK. And then we can just drag and drop this Flathead Lake sequence, keep the existing settings, and then as we scrub through, we can see all of the images together, but we need to zoom out because the framing is not correct. So over here, we're just going to scale this back like so until it looks good. And it's a little bit crooked here, so I'm going to -3 to the rotation just so it looks good. And then what we can do is just render in and out. And after it's done rendering, we can play it back to see how it looks.
All right, you guys, that's it to creating a time lapse with the RX100 and the Syrup. Once again, the links are in my description box below to both the products if you guys want to check it out. If you guys have any questions about anything that I covered, don't be shy and be sure to leave a comment below. And if you guys like this format of me doing tutorial hands-on with cameras, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if it gets to 5,000 likes, then we know that this is the type of video that you guys like. So that's it, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.